एज एन एक्सपेरिमेंटल काइंड ऑफ अ पर्सन, आई ऑलवेज ट्राई टू से करके देखते हैं क्या होता है, वो करके देखते हैं क्या होता है कि चक्कर में टुडे आई एम सिटिंग हियर. वो आई जस्ट ट्राइड आउट ऑफ माई इंजीनियरिंग के यार ये करके देखते हैं क्या होता है. हाउ डू यू, आई हैव नॉट इवन एक्टेड इन अ स्कूल प्ले इन माई लाइफ. छोले भटूरे, दैट वॉज माई केक ऑन माई बर्थडे ऑल्सो. छोले भटूरे, दैट वॉज माई केक. या बिकॉज आई लव छोले भटूरे, आई लव माई टिक्कीज एंड ऑल दैट. सो आई एम मोर ऑफ अ स्पाइस ईटिंग पर्सन. So I'm more like a bigger fan of those all spicy food and all fried food.
But how did you manage to like leave all that, or did you leave that, or do you secretly
So let me tell you, I didn't leave any of it. But I have my those cheat days where I make sure. I think jitna crave karenge, I think we just try to force ourselves, our bodies away from it. The more we crave for it, and then we end up eating it anyway, and then like putting it on. So rather just keep one day aside for this. I think life is only this much, yeah. We can't really
what
give
is it
up.
Like Sunday cheat day.
I don't have fixed days. I just make sure it's only once in a week. That's all.
So Sunday and Monday.
It can be any day. But it should be only once in 7 days. So it cannot be every third day.
But it's amazing the kind of roles that you've been picking up. And you know, I wanted to know, do you do the stunts yourself?
Yeah, I do it myself. You are more than welcome to come on my sets and see me jumping. I think I was born to just do stunts off camera. Now on camera, I've been jumping from my balconies and like running away when I need to go and play and my door was locked. I've done all those kind of things. So it's only natural that now I'm finally doing all those action films.
How young were you when you realized I'm a stunt person?
I was pretty young when I realized the world which is realizing me now. I realized it back then. I used to do all those stunts on the cycles, like which I don't tell everyone to do, but then I was just skid and all, like have those races in the streets of Delhi. So I've been a pretty stunt savvy person since childhood, and food savvy person even more. Yeah, I live to eat. Yeah, I think.
Are you somewhat of a nerd also? Because
I am a nerd. Yeah. I used to have -3.5 power glasses, braces. Talk about it and I had it all. yeah, that's it. And I used to be, so I've never been fat kid. But being a Sardani, I used to have this solid build. And trust me, one makhan slice also shows on my body if I eat it. So I have to work harder to like burn it all out. But yeah, I've never been a fat kid, but I've been a very super healthy in the sense. So hamare country mein na, jab a person becomes a little fat, usko fat bolte se sharmate hai. So people say, you're a healthy kid.
so
I'm like very healthy. Khate peete ghar ki ladki hai.
But how do you do this? How are you like all bubbly and you know, you live on humor, but on set your roles are very serious.
I know, I have so many encounters where people come and tell me, yaar tum real life mein to itni serious nahi ho. I think then I just very proudly say, you know, I can act a little bit. Nahi, but wo kya hasne khelne wale role itne mile nahi, baki sab को मिल गया आसानी से. मेरे हाथ में सिर्फ वो सीरियस वाले आए तो आई हैड टू टेक इट अप. या नो, बट देन आई एम अ वेरी गूफी, वेरी वेरी वेल, इट्स काइंड ऑफ नॉट रियली मॉडेस्ट टू से आई एम अ फनी पर्सन इन रियल लाइफ, बट आई एम क्वाइट गूफी. आई से आई लिव ऑन सरकास्टिक ह्यूमर ऑलमोस्ट. पीपल रियली नीड टू थिंक हार्ड बिफोर दे अंडरस्टैंड कि मैंने जोक मारा है कि एक्चुअली मैं मतलब सीरियसली डू आई इंटेंड टू से इट. सो आई लिव ऑन ह्यूमर, आई लव ह्यूमर. I'm not at all a serious person. I don't even take myself seriously in real life. लाइफ, बट वो मेरी फिल्म में काफी सीरियस होती है. पीपल गेट लाइक दे आर लाइक इन अ स्टेट ऑफ शॉक आफ्टर मीटिंग मी फॉर अ कपल ऑफ मिनट्स. इट्स द सेम गर्ल हु वी सॉ इन दोस फिल्म्स.
सो तापसी द स्टंट वुमन, तापसी द
आई लव यू, आई एम जैक ऑफ ऑल ट्रेड्स, मास्टर ऑफ नन.
प्रोबब्ली स्टैंड अप कॉमेडियन आल्सो.
या आई हैव गॉटन इनटू ट्रबल्स विद माय कॉमेडी, सो it doesn't go down well, my comedy doesn't go down well with people. As I said, I'm a jack of all trades and I'm master of none. That's how it
on
is.
On that note, I think we'll open it to the crowd. Yeah, do you have any questions from the audience?
From engineering to films, how has the transition been? And why? I mean...
I like this why bit. Why would you do it? It's like my grandmom asking me question, kyun? Yeah, it's the same question I keep answering back home every day, why? So there was just, I am a very adventurous and experimental kind of a person. I always try to say, karke dekhte hain kya hota hai. Wo karke dekhte hain kya hota hai ke chakkar mein today I'm sitting here. I just tried out of my engineering ke yaar ye karke dekhte hain kya hota hai. How do you, I have not even acted in a school play in my life. No acting background whatsoever, no classes. मतलब ड्रामा में भी पार्टिसिपेट नहीं किया मैंने अपनी लाइफ में इससे पहले. सो सडनली इट वॉज जस्ट आउट ऑफ एडवेंचर, लेट्स सी क्या होता है, करके देखते हैं क्या होगा. एंड आई हैड टाइम टू डू दैट एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड थैंकफुली माई पेरेंट्स लेट मी डू दैट एक्सपेरिमेंट बिकॉज दे वर प्रीटी यूज टू इट बाय देन टू सी मी डूइंग सम रियली क्रेजी आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स स्टफ. एंड देन न्यू जिसको जितना इसको मना करोगे ना ये मत कर उतना आई वुड वॉन्ट टू डू इट. सो दैट थिंग वर्क फॉर मी. एंड आई थिंक माई लक लाइन हैज़ बिन stronger than my lifeline. I always say that my luck has really favored me a lot in a lot of places. So that's precisely here. And I never took things for granted. So when I gave it my 100%. Otherwise I will not do it. It's just out of happiness that I do things, and that's why you can probably see me happy in real. Huh? Filmon mein nahi lagti hu, but main real mein bahut happy hu. I am already doing that, yeah. I have experimented, like, I think 2 years back, I started a wedding planning company for myself, which was purely out of thing to start a business, which has got nothing to do with films. I didn't want to have a business in films. So probably I'll continue starting these small startups, which have got nothing to do with films, something totally independent of it. Pure out of fun of experimentation, and now that God has given decent enough to do this experiment, I can take the risk of doing that. Yeah. यार अनुराग कश्यप ने आज तक मुझे किसी स्क्रिप्ट के लिए भी अप्रोच नहीं किया है, पता नहीं कौन सी पिक्चर की बात हो रही है. नो आई डोंट नो इफ यू टॉकिंग अबाउट डायरेक्टोरियल और प्रोडक्शन, आई डोंट नो. बट अभी तक मैंने कुछ साइन नहीं किया है. आई विल बी प्राउडली अनाउंसिंग इट, वट एवर आई साइन आई वुड बी मोर देन हैप्पी टू अनाउंस इट. आई यू वोंट हैव टू वेट फॉर एनी रूमर.
हाय दैट्स माय नेम इज खुशबू. या जस्ट लाइक योर रोज माय क्वेश्चन इज अ सीरियस वन. It is a fact that top male actors earn at least 5 times more than the female actresses.
Hmm. And sometimes even 10.
Yeah, exactly. So despite such appalling reality, movies like Finding Fanny, Highway or Mary Kom and even Naam Shabana, it has proved that the audience doesn't only go to watch the heroes.
Hmm.
So how do you see this income disparity?
How many movies of such sort do you actually come across in a year? Probably 1-2 maximum, right? So it's kind of unfair to ask for an equal pay when you're not getting an equal amount of opening collection. The day we, the audience walks into theaters and sees a female protagonist film and gives us same amount of bumper opening of 10 crores, 15 crores and all that, that day I will say, you know, we need to be paid equally. Right now I think it's a little unfair for producers to give us an equal amount of money, because no matter how good the film is, like my film probably this year had the highest opening for a female protagonist film and it was a little above 5. So and if you compare it with all the leading male protagonists today in the industry, they get far higher, most of them. So it's just unfair for me to demand the same price. I think first the audience needs to come in and give me that bumper opening, then I'll ask for the equal pay.
So you've been known to be ekdam, how do they say, mufat.
Oh God, don't say, I hate that term.
But it's true.
I'm just honest. That's, let's just let move what is makes it very like very crass. Let's make it, I'm very honest person. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is Hollywood on your card anytime soon?
Is Hollywood offering me any film? Yeah, if I'm not gonna go there and ask for it, let's just say that. If it comes my way, because even when I started off in South or Bollywood for that matter, it's not like I went there and I asked for work. As I said, I've been very lucky. So if I get an opportunity sitting here doing the work I'm doing, I don't mind trying it. But I don't think I'm going there trying to make it in Hollywood.
But were you always a Bollywood person?
I've never been a Bollywood person.
A
yeah.
Movie watching.
Yeah, of course. You know, all of us have grown up and watching films. So I've been watching films, but it's not like your first day, first show, jaake hi first. You know, I have to see it this weekend. Yeah. I've been watching films while growing up.
Which is that one role you would have loved to do?
Yeah, Bollywood concern. Like right now, if you ask me, lately that people have been asking me this question, I have one answer that comes to my head is Gone Girl's character.
Mm.
That I would love to do. Since I'm known to be doing little off things.
That's a
things.
Very sadistic joke. I'm a little scared of you now.
Yeah, but I see the black humor there. I see the black humor.
Hi,
Tapni.
Hi. I'm very good, thank you.
So,
yeah, that's true.
Yeah, so what do you think, like, you have been, portrayed as a stereotypical in a serious avatar, what is your take on it? Like?
You haven't seen Judhva as yet, trust me. I'm looking forward to all of your reaction when you see Judhva. See, I've done Judhva sort of films most of my life in film industry. You guys haven't seen my South films, so that's why you probably haven't seen me in that avatar. And those people are getting shocked seeing me in serious roles because they haven't seen me in serious roles. So it's very contradictory. Wait for Judhva. Judhva, your opinion is going to change quite a bit where my perception is concerned. But at the end of the day, you know, I have built a certain image which I'm really proud of. The fact that I take up characters which have depth or meaning and that can impact my audience for a long time. And I wouldn't want to give that up, yeah. You know, I will get back to doing serious stuff or thrillers or whatever, dramas and all. Because I've built a certain image because of those films. I'm extremely proud of that image. I have nothing like, you know, I have to shed that image. I don't have that. I'll be versatile. I'll do a Judhva also in between. But it's not like I'm ashamed of having that image of mine.
One of your serious roles was in Baby, where you shared a screen space with Akshay Kumar.
Hmm.
So did he give you any of fitness diets on sets?
Because he's extremely fit.
Oh, he's very fit. No, I mean, he didn't give me any tips. He used to just be concerned about the fact that I'm happy doing those stunts. It's not like I'm forced to do those stunts and I'm not liking it. And I'm making sure I'm taking enough safety precautions because he used to always say that, you know, if you're liking it and you are safe, is only when you can do it for a longer time. So that is what his concern was, you know, if I'm doing it safely and if I'm enjoying it or no. He never used to give me any diet tips or, you know, workout tips because I don't think he probably felt that I needed.
This is a question I ask everyone who's done a film with Akshay. Is that how early did you have to wake up?
Listen, I'm myself a morning person, so I totally identify with Akshay. My day starts around 7:30 every day, not as early as his. But I mean, I sleep by 11 o'clock. I'm not a night person at all. In fact, even I detest night shoots. So after 11 o'clock, my brain shuts.
So are you the one who sleeps in the corner in a nightclub?
People have stopped taking me to nightclubs now. Like, my sister has blacklisted me from all the groups and she's like, you're not allowed to even come out with us because I'm the biggest party pooper. I'm just the most nagging and annoying person in a nightclub. So people have stopped taking me now. If you make me jump from some really crazy height without any protection, then I might end up doing that because I want to keep doing films for a longer time.
I'm Josh from Stardust.
Yeah.
Is there any particular genre you want to stick to?
Never. I think it's suicidal for an actor to do that, to stick to one particular genre.
Say Shah Rukh Khan, he's done
a lot of other things also. I don't call Chak De a rom-com. And for me, if you ask me, that's the first Shah Rukh Khan film that comes to my head. Dar or you know, Jagdev. For me, that is what tops the list. Yeah.
How working in South is different than working in Bollywood?
Apart from language, nothing else, actually. Yeah. And that is all the problems or problems in terms of, you know, how much you can experiment comes because of the language, I feel. So apart from language, I don't see much of the scale of the film is the same. You know, the magnitude with which you make the film is equally big or small. It varies. The treatment, in fact, actually the South treats you more like a queen. You know, you feel over pampered and spoiled there.
I was watching an EIC video where you were talking about the South films.
Yeah. I don't know, what did you interpret out of it? I am still trying to understand how people interpreted whatever they interpreted out of it. So I'm still like, I hope you saw the entire 15 minutes and not the 10 seconds played on the loop. Yeah. Did you laugh at it? Please don't laugh right now, because if this goes viral, I'll be in a soup again.
Yes, yeah, yeah. Like last two questions. Yeah.
How did you prepare for your stance for Naam Shabana?
I had a intensive, almost close to an year long training. Yeah, immediately after baby, I think 2 months after baby, I got to know that I'm going to do this. So I started off my training then and there, and we had to add a few martial art techniques apart from Krav Maga. Krav Maga is what I learned for baby, and then I added Aikido, I added MMA to those techniques, and then I was training there onwards till the release and every time before any stunt sequence. So there were like at least 4 to 5 stunt sequences in the film, and every sequence had a different type of training involved before I used to go on floor to shoot it. So there was a continuous training for like months. I had to go through that training every day, 2 hours of training.
And finally, to end this interview, what's next for Tapsee Pannu?
Yeah,
after Judwa.
See, I have 2 films right now. Of course, you people know about Judwa. I have 18th August, my Ananda Brahma Telugu film of mine releasing in Telugu industry. That is what I'm looking forward to immediately. Soon after, we'll release a trailer of Judwa 2, and then I have 29 September Judwa 2. After that, Mulk is what I should be doing next. I really need to start working on it for you to tell you what exactly is going to happen and when it's going to release and all that. But yeah, I am in talks with people
and
who
are
making
movies. Are you looking at web series? Because Inside Edge was something that really...
I haven't seen the series. I would love to have... I know Angad is in the film and I know him well. So I would love to see the web series. I've been approached for a few. But doing web series, of course, it is the future. But I'm already getting to do the out-of-the-box roles,
right,
which people try to experiment in doing web series, which probably not a lot of people get to do in films. But thankfully, by God's grace, I'm getting to do out-of-the-box stuff in films so far. So far, I don't really have the time or don't really feel the need to immediately do a web series. Let's see in the future if I feel like.
Awesome. On that note, I think we'll close this interview. Please give it a huge round of applause.
Thank you guys. Sorry for the delay, guys.